Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I want to show you a holster I got for my Smith X-Frame with a 3.5-inch barrel. Now, this holster is made by Simply Rugged. Before I go on, I just want to say I've owned, a few Simply Rugged holsters in the past, and I have to say that their quality is very consistent. Their lead times are also very consistent. So, if you're looking for a custom holster, I would say check out Simply Rugged just because, like I said, quality is consistent and they have a consistent 10 business day lead time. If you want to go the Milt Sparks route or Kramer Gun Leather, Mitch Rosen, what have you, any one of these custom makers, you could be waiting upwards to 3 months before getting a rig. So Simply Rugged is another option you guys should check out. Now this holster here is made for an X frame, so I'm sure a lot of you guys out there may not be interested in this, but I figured I'd just do this video anyways for entertainment purposes and for curiosity's sake. Now, since I did the video on this specific revolver right here, I actually got 5 emails from some various YouTubers out there who own a 460 Magnum. Two guys actually have this specific one. One guy has the emergency survival version, which is like a, what is that, the 2 3/4 inch barrel. It's got that odd barrel length. And the other guy has a 5-inch version. So you guys were offering me a lot of information about the 460 Magnum and what you do with them. Now, most of these guys just have them for fun, for entertainment use, just to shoot them. One guy does take it out into the woods. He's from, I guess, Wyoming. And he has a 5-inch version, and he does hunt with it. So he has a different perspective. And any of you guys out there that have any thoughts, opinions, or if you're you have a lot of knowledge about the 460 Magnum, and this specific revolver, or any 460 revolver, please help me out and leave some comments below. Let me know what you think about it, what do you do with it, how do you use it, what ammunition do you use, what have you. All right, let's get on with this. Basically, this is a loaded pancake model. And what that means is it's a pancake holster, so you can use it as a concealment holster. I know that's an oxymoron trying to conceal this, but let's keep on going here. So it's a pancake holster where they sew on these loop loaders right on the freaking holster like that. See that? So you can carry some extra cartridges right here, right on the holster. So that's what they call the loaded pancake. And it's a very ingenious design. I like it. It's pretty cool. The first thing I noticed when I got this, took it out of the box, was that this specific holster seemed more stronger, tougher, more defined. You know, there's more definition in the way this was molded than my other Simply Rugged holsters. Now, there was an upcharge for this specific one of $10. I don't know if that means they have to use more leather or there's more time involved in molding this, because this one definitely feels different than any other Simply Rugged holster I own. It's just something about it that just makes it a lot different. I like the way it looks. I got it in Oxblood, which is my favorite color by Simply Rugged. And let's just talk about this. So let's just say you want to load up some rounds in these loop loaders. How does that work? As example, look at this 460 Magnum. Every time I see this round right here, it gives me chills. This is a no joke of a 460 Magnum, this Hornady. A guy at the range is going to supply me with some. I guess he's going to bring them next time. I think it's Winchester Super X. He says it's a low recoil 460 Magnum, if there is such a thing. It's a 250 grain jacketed hollow point, and he says it's much more manageable than these ones right here coming out of a 3.5-inch barrel. So we'll see about that. But anyways, you can load them up just like that. These are 460 Magnums. Look at that. Look how far down they... It just looks like a rifle cartridge. It's just really cool to me. But anyways, or a 454 Casull can go in there. Or a 45 Colt. All right, so these are all the same diameter. The 460, 454, and 45 Colt. Basically, it's a 45 caliber. So that's basically what it looks like. And you can load up all those rounds right on the actual holster itself. All right. Now let's just say we want to load this gun in there, right? This revolver. Oh, man, every time I open the cylinder, it's just... All right, we're safe. Now imagine loading up this cylinder right here with 5 rounds of, we'll say, 460 Magnums. And then inserting this revolver into this pancake holster. Now having this on your side, all right, on your strong side, what do we got going on? Guys, you can go to the gym and use this as a weight. This is some heavy duty stuff right here. I'm talking more than 4 pounds of weight right there. Loaded cylinder, loaded up loop loaders, the gun itself. How practical is it to carry this on your strong side? Not very practical by any means. You will need a double thick gun belt, such as a Zax gun belt, to be able to sustain this much weight on your hip, for real. If you try, and if you think you can use a Wally World belt, forget it, it's just gonna fall off. I mean, they'll just twist and turn off your side. So even with a Zax gun belt that's double thick, you know, I mean, it's supporting this much weight, but it's not comfortable by any means. It's almost intolerable. It really depends. I have carried this in this fashion a bunch of times this week just for kicks and for ha-has. And yeah, I mean, I went out into the woods with this just to, you know, test it out. It's, if this is not in the sweet spot, you're gonna be annoyed to no end. This massive cylinder right here, all right? This part, if you can see that, how it's wearing out right there, that part of the cylinder is rubbing up against my side on my hip and really digging in. So within, I'd say, half an hour of walking around in the woods with this on my side, it gets really tiring, it starts to hurt your hip, and you're just like, oh man, this sucks. So you move it around to the maybe a sweet spot, and it gets somewhat more tolerable, but really it's not that practical. I can do it, but how many people are gonna carry something like this on their hip, fully loaded, rounds in the loop loaders with an X frame? This is a ton of weight, guys, a ton of weight. So it's not very practical at all, but I did it anyways just to check it out, see how it is. And you know, I don't think I would want to have this on my hip for more than an hour. All right, I think it would just be too much. It would just be tiring, fatiguing, and your hip's gonna hurt unless you move this around to a different angle. But I like the concept of this holster. I really do. I think it's a very attractive looking Simply Rugged holster because it has such a definition to it than their other ones. I don't know why that is. They just made it differently. But it definitely can support the X frame. It's definitely got good retention. Okay. And it's a good holster. But in all practicality, I don't think it's that practical to carry an X frame on your strong side hip. You can do it, you definitely can, but how long can you do it? It becomes that kind of a test of time. The other thing is, would anyone ever conceal this? Probably not, but I did just for kicks and ha-has. Is it concealable? No, it's not, because this thing is so big, you're going to have to wear like a gown to basically conceal this. But it can be done under a jacket. So I leave that up to you guys. It's pretty funny. So there you go, I'm just kind of showing it to you. In my usual fashion, I'll show you what it looks like on my person and maybe how you might be able to conceal it and stuff like that if you so want to, if you want to do something like that. You know, again, we go back to what is the purpose of something like this. It's mainly for, you know, enjoyment, you know, or again, you can use it as a woods gun, but I'm still struggling to understand what round to use in this as a woods defense gun. Come on, are you really going to put 460 magnums in here, you know, without hearing protection? That's just very dangerous. I do want to share with you one little story before I show you what this looks like on my person. I was at a range, and I had this on me with using this holster, all right? I didn't have any ammunition in the loop loaders just because I didn't want to freak anybody out at this range. And just for kicks, I had it concealed, all right? Just for kicks. I got up to the line to basically blast one round of 460 magnum out of this. I was basically using 45 Colt plus P's, but I said I'm gonna just shoot one 460 magnum out of it. And I do that, and three older gentlemen came up to me and asked me, what the hell are you shooting? What the hell is that thing? And I had this on my hip, all right, in this holster, just like this on my hip. And one of the guys, I believe, was he was just a cop, he was a police officer, and he's like, what is that thing? What is it? And I said, okay, well, make it safe, take it out. And they're like, oh my God, what the hell? And I let them, you know, look at it, hold it. And they were just amazed at this revolver, guys. The cop, you know, he said something that kind of bothered me. He basically said, do you carry that, like, when you leave here? Like, is it on your hip? I'm like, yeah. It's like, so you carry that when you're out and about? To be funny, I just said, oh yeah, I do. Yeah, I carry this, conceal carry it. Just to be funny. And he goes like, you know what? That thing needs to be banned. I'm like, oh, this guy must be just messing around. He's like, what kind of round does that take? And I show him this. He says, yeah, that thing has to be banned. They got to ban that thing, that gun, and that ammunition has to be banned, because if someone can actually carry something like that out there, you know, these rounds could penetrate vests, you know, cars and stuff like that. You know, that shouldn't, you know, that should be banned. And I'm thinking to myself, this guy is serious. And I kind of said to him, no, actually, I do not carry this. I carry a 357 Magnum, actually. And he's like, well, still, you know, if someone could have the capability of carrying that revolver out there, I mean, it's going to put us in danger. And I was telling him, all right, number one, what street criminal is going to get their hands on this? And even if they did, they wouldn't even know what the hell this thing is. They wouldn't even know what ammunition to use. How would they get this stuff? Even if they got this stuff, they wouldn't be able to control this thing. And the likelihood of this being used on the streets, right, guys? So that kind of like irked me a little bit with him saying we've got to ban this. Come on, everyone wants to ban everything here. It's just pathetic. But all right, that was just a quick story. All right, let's get going here. Let me show you what this thing looks like on my person.
All right, so let's check out what this holster looks like on my person. I got the sourdough loaded pancake holster on my strong side hip. And guys, this is one massive holster. We got some rounds loaded up in these loop loaders, five of them. And just imagine if you had this cylinder loaded up with five more rounds of 460 Magnum, how much weight is this? You know, and you're walking through the woods, all right, what have you. Is this practical? Not at all, guys. There is so much weight on my hip right here. I feel off kilter and I'm being like pulled to the side like that. That's how much weight is on your hip right here. So you must have a double thick gun belt to sustain this much weight if you're gonna do this kind of system. But in reality, it's not very practical. If you wanna carry it for a short term period of time, or you can tolerate this, hey, more power to you, then do it. But this is what it looks like. I don't think it's that practical. It's not a concealment holster by any means, okay? This is not a concealed carry revolver. I mean, guys, this revolver's purpose is as a backup for dangerous game. If you're out there hunting, hiking, you run into grizzly bears, you know, stuff like that, moose, large animals that are dangerous, you could use this as a defensive, I guess, revolver against animals like that. If you're out in Wyoming, Montana, freaking Alaska, Kodiak Island, or whatever, then yeah, okay, that makes sense. But hey, if you want to carry this as a concealed revolver, concealed carry revolver, loaded up with some 45 Colt plus P's, what have you, more power to you. If you want to conceal it, take a vest, all right? And I don't know, if you're hiking and you don't want other hikers that you're gonna pass by see that you're armed, you know, freak them out, what have you, you can conceal it in this fashion, all right? Does pretty well. And then if something were to arise and you needed to use this, you know, just like a concealed carry, a weapon that you carry, it's the same type of fashion, same manual of arms. It's just that this thing is massive and huge. So showing you that. But I guess that's all I really wanted to show you guys. It's really not that practical, but I think it's very interesting. It's fun, it's kind of cool, but really, are you gonna be carrying like this type of revolver? I don't think so. I think there's a better way to carry this behemoth of a revolver. So that's it, guys. Leave some comments below. Let me know what you think. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.